Hi, I'm Bob Berry, and today we're going to talk about how to avoid electrocution injuries when conducting lifting operations near power lines. Electrocution hazards have consistently caused more fatalities on construction sites than any other type of accident. Job site safety begins with an overall awareness of your surroundings at all times. It is very important to do a walk-around assessment of the job site prior to setting up the crane. During a walk-around, always make notes where power lines and underground utilities exist and plan your access route accordingly. OSHA regulation provides three options for working close to power lines. De-energize and ground. Mark and maintain 20-foot clearance. Refer to Table A clearance. When working within 20 foot of the power line, the 2010 OSHA rules require that you refer to Table A for proper clearance. Only if the voltage of the power lines are known and verified with the line owner. When possible, it is always safe to de-energize the line by contacting the utility owner. Once the clearance requirement is known, the OSHA 1926-1408 standard requires the controlling entity to mark hazard areas at ground level and with an elevated line to indicate the safe operating limits. And a designated spotter must always watch this area when using Table A. Cones or flags should also be used to mark other utilities, voids, and hazards. And remember, proper planning, awareness of surroundings, good communication always makes for a safe lift. Thanks for watching and sharing our video, and look for another Sims Crane Minute coming soon.